Southeastern Savage Storm have had an up-and-down start to the season, alternating wins and losses over their first four games. Today, Coach Ray Richards turned to a player who's had an up-and-down career. Justin Petruca is a two-time All-Division quarterback, but was kicked off the team last year after a drug conviction. Now he's back on the team and back in the starting lineup as the Savage Storm take on Northwestern Oklahoma State. There's Petruca. Back under center, and he's going to be flushed from the pocket. He's going to pick up the first down, but the offensive line coach is not very happy. I don't know what fatten around is exactly, but that means Jerome Hewitt is definitely not fatten around. He takes the punt, 76 yards for the touchdown, and Southeastern is on the board 6-0. And then just before halftime, here is Josh Johnson taking the pitch, number 19, up the middle, untouched for 49 yards. 13-0 Savage Storm at the half, and that's where we are now, late in the third. Southeastern winning the battle of the directional schools. Elsewhere in Texoma, the East Central Tigers and Austin College are also playing today. We'll have scores at 10. The Texas Longhorns outlasted a tough Texas Tech squad last Saturday night, prompting Mack Brown to say, "I think we're going to be really, really good." Today, the Horns got the chance to beat up on a really, really bad team, the Miners of Texas El Paso. It's 7-0 Texas in the first quarter, but whoops, Colt McCoy picked off by Melvin Stevenson. He will take it home, and we're all tied at 7. Could there be an upset in the making down in Austin? No. Ensuing kickoff, as kickoffs often ensue, it's DJ Monroe taking the ball and then taking off. 92 yards on the return, and Texas goes back on top 13-7. It's 16-7 when McCoy avoids those squiggly white lines and finds Dan Buckner. He will take it 36 yards to the corner, and now it's 23-7 Horns. We move to the second quarter. More from the guys in burnt orange. Jordan Shipley takes the pass from McCoy for a touchdown. That makes it 33-7, and the route is on. Vondrell McGee takes the pitch, breaks tackles, and breaks the hearts of the Miners as Texas puts the L in El Paso, 64-7. Elsewhere in the Big 12, Kansas survives a close game with Southern Miss. Oklahoma State just underway against Grambling. And Texas Tech is actually an underdog on the road tonight against Houston. Oklahoma has the week off, but the Sooners got to watch their next opponent, Miami, on the road against Virginia Tech. But Ja'Cory Harris is hit and fumbles. Cordero Thompson falls on it. That would lead to a Hokie touchdown, and Virginia Tech leads 7-0. Now it's Tyrod Taylor looking for Jarrett Boykin all alone on the pass play. 50 yards, and it's 14-0 Hokies. Miami is back to punt, but it's going to be blocked by Cam Chancellor. Matt Reedy's going to pick it up, and it's 21-0 Hokies, and Miami goes down for the first time this season, 31-7. The Sooners play at Miami next Saturday. Number 15, TCU on the road in Death Valley against Clemson. Andy Dalton is tipped at the line of scrimmage, but it goes right into the hands of Ed Wesley. That ends up being a 58-yard gain for Wesley, and that sets up the Horned Frogs inside the 10. And so here comes Dalton, the play action, and Curtis Clay with a nice grab in the end zone makes it 7-3 Horned Frogs. Late in the second quarter, Kyle Parker from Clemson hits C.J. Spiller down the middle of the field, 60 yards on the play. Spiller would punch it in for a Clemson halftime lead, but TCU comes back to win it 14-10, and the Horned Frogs are still undefeated. On the scoreboard today, a sick Tim Tebow and number one Florida are destroying the Kentucky Wildcats. Number three Alabama makes short work of Arkansas, and number six California blown out on the road at Oregon. And that's a quick look at sports, Daniel.